So for the final story of the day, we get to talk about the Apple Watch. Oh, and I am excited about this, ladies and gentlemen. I just actually switched over to Samsung, so I'm not going to get it. But I love this technology because I feel like this is just the door opening, just a creak, just a crack, just so we can see what technology can do in healthcare in the future. I think it's a beautiful thing. So why am I excited and why am I talking about the Apple Watch and the nursing news? Is because this new Apple Watch can do something crazy for your health. It can take an EKG. That is amazing to me. So for those regular folk out there and for those nurses that don't remember what an EKG is, let me explain to you. An EKG is just it's a diagnostic test that measures the electrical activity that that's going on in your heart, because that's how your heart works. You know, electrical activity makes it squeeze the atria and then the ventricles. And that's how your heart communicates with itself, so it beats correctly, right? And when you take an EKG of someone, you get to see that electrical activity on the paper, and then they'll decide, is it normal? Is it abnormal? Is it too fast? Is it too slow? The whole nine, right? And after an EKG, and like I just said, you can check if it's normal. You can diagnose. You can say someone has AFib. You can say someone has AFib, which is just an irregular heartbeat, right? Or you can tell if someone's heartbeat is going too fast or too slow, and that's what you would use an EKG for. And so for those who've never seen it, you'll see, I'll put up a picture of a regular EKG that you might find in some hospitals, and that is, it's a humongous thing, and it's just meant for one thing, to take an EKG. And to put that machine in an Apple Watch that is used mainly for 1,000 other things, and it also does an EKG, I think is fantastical. But don't get too excited, because at every hospital you go to, the main EKG you use is a 12-lead EKG, right? So they put these stickers on, it's just called a 12-lead EKG because it has 12 leads, and it sticks on 12 different parts of your body. And so they can get they can see the electric activity of the entire heart, so they don't miss anything, right? The Apple Watch is basically a one-lead EKG, and you might ask a simple question as, is it useful to have a one-lead EKG when you guys use a 12? Yes, it is. It's very, very, very helpful to have a one-lead EKG, and you can't see abnormal activities going on with the heart with any lead EKG. It does the same exact thing as a 12-lead EKG with just less detail. So if a healthcare professional were to look at an EKG as one lead versus 12 leads, if they know what they're looking for, they'll be able to find it, right? They're not going to use an Apple Watch's EKG to diagnose things, but it's helpful to have. So if you do check your, do use the app to check your EKG and it looks funky and the Apple Watch says that this is abnormal, it will tell you, go get checked at the hospital. And I'm all about prevention, because I think prevention is the best medication, it's the best treatment, it's the best of all everything, right? So if an Apple Watch is telling you might want to go check out go to the doctors, versus you passing out because your heart stopped or it skipped the beat, that is so much better, right? It is so much better to go to the hospital and say, my watch is telling me that my heart's not functioning right. Can we do something about it? Versus you passing out, getting CPR, then going to the hospital, right? Well, that's what we all want. That's what we all want. So what we know right now is the Apple Watch, the ECG app can give you two heart rhythms, normal and AFib. The Apple Watch isn't going to be able to tell the difference between junctional rhythm and all the different arrhythmias. It's not going to be able to tell you what kind of heart block you have. It's not there. Like I said, it's one lead versus the 12 leads we use at the hospital, but it's something. And if it's not AFib and it's not normal, it will say on your watch, it is not normal, but it's not AFib, go to the hospital. And I think that's as much as the information that you want into the public's hands, so they can come in and say, this is what the Apple Watch is saying. I am concerned. Should I be concerned? Do we need to do anything? I love it. I love it. I love it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate this. If you guys were informed or educated in any way, shape, or form by these stories, please hit that like button. If you liked my presentation of the news, I really suggest you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you know every time Q the Nurse drops some hot, fresh, pressed news. Thank you. Catch you next week. Deuces.